Welcome to a lesson on Eulerization. Not every graph has an Euler path or Euler circuit. However, there is often still the goal of finding an Euler path or circuit. If a graph does not have an Euler path or circuit, one can be created by duplicating edges. As an example, consider a police officer patrolling a neighborhood on foot, wanting to minimize the amount of walking. If this is a diagram of the neighborhood, and the police officer is required to walk down each street at least once, if the police officer wants to minimize walking, the officer might want to park their vehicle here, walk down each street exactly once, and return to the vehicle, which means the officer would like to find an Euler circuit for this neighborhood. We can represent this neighborhood using this graph here. In order for an Euler circuit to exist, the degree of each vertex must be even. Let's begin by determining the degree of each vertex. Notice how these vertices all have degree 2. This vertex has degree 4, but the remaining 4 vertices have degree 3. So because not all the vertices have an even degree, there is no Euler circuit, which means in order to patrol the neighborhood, the officer is going to have to duplicate his efforts and walk down certain streets more than once. Now, to create an Euler circuit, we'll duplicate edges so all the degrees are even. And we cannot create new edges, we can only duplicate existing edges. So we cannot connect these two vertices here because this is creating a new edge, which is not allowed. We can think of this as trying to create a street through someone's property, which would not be allowed. And because we cannot connect the odd vertices directly, we'll have to duplicate edges along a path. So for example, we want to connect this vertex to this vertex. We have to duplicate this edge as well as this edge. Notice now the degree of this vertex is 4, and so is this. The degree of this vertex is now 6. But now we also have to connect this vertex to this vertex. So we'll duplicate this edge and this edge. So now this vertex has degree 4, and so does this. And this vertex now has degree 8. And now because all the vertices have an even degree, we can create an Euler circuit using this graph. Notice how the duplicate edges would represent where the officer would have to walk down a street twice. Let's go ahead and formalize the Eulerization process. Eulerization is the process of adding edges to create an Euler circuit. It can also be used to create an Euler path. To Eulerize a graph, edges are duplicated to connect pairs of vertices with odd degree. Connecting two odd vertices increases the degree of each by 1, giving both an even degree. When two odd vertices are not directly connected, as we saw in our example, we can duplicate all the edges in a path connecting the two. Let's take a look at another example. We want to Eulerize the given graph. We want to try to find the shortest path if the edges represent distance and are drawn to scale, then find an Euler circuit. So because the edges are drawn to scale and represent distance, when we start duplicating edges, we want to try to duplicate the short edges rather than the longer edges. But let's begin by checking the degree of each vertex. Notice how we have degree 3, degree 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. Each vertex has degree 3. But notice in this example, unlike the first, we are able to connect the odd vertices directly. But again, because we're trying to minimize the total distance, we won't duplicate edge AB, we'll duplicate edge AH instead. Because it's shorter, it represents the distance would be less. So we'll duplicate AH here, we'll duplicate BG here, we'll duplicate CF here, and duplicate DE here. Notice by doing this, now each vertex has degree 4, which is even, and now we can find an Euler circuit. So let's say we start at vertex A. We now want to use each edge exactly once, and we finish, return to vertex A. So let's go from vertex A to vertex B to begin. Then let's go from B to G. and then from G back to B, and then from B to C. And again, let's go from C to F, F back to C, C to D, that would be 7, and from D to A, from A to H. Now we'll go around the inner square, so H to E, that'd be 10. We forgot to go here, so let's go ahead and go E to D, and then D back to E, and then E to F, F to G, G to H, and finally return back to A, so H to A. So this would be a possible Euler circuit. Let's go ahead and give it as a list. Again, we started at A, then B, G back to B, to C, to F to C, to D, and then A, to H, to E, to D back to E, to F, to G, H, and then A. And of course, there are several other possibilities. The problem of finding the optimal Eulerization is called the Chinese postman problem, a name given by an American in honor of the Chinese mathematician Mei Kuo Quan, who first studied the problem in 1962 while trying to find optimal delivery routes for postal carriers. This problem is important in determining efficient routes for garbage trucks, school buses, parking meter checkers, street sweepers, and many other applications. Unfortunately, algorithms to solve this problem are fairly complex. I think we'll go ahead and stop here on this lesson. I hope you found this helpful.